So the law of phenomena essentially states that your body is working perfectly all the time, always in your best interest, constantly adapting to the current stressors of life. It works in such a fashion as to maintain or regain its health at the highest possible level based upon the cumulative effects of the substances, forces, influences, and condition to which you have subjected yourself.
Yes.
It will do this throughout your entire life. A blister, a headache, a nausea, sunburn, constipation, or any other symptom is generated perfectly in an effort to reinstate the healthiest possible result given the immediate situation. This innate intelligence that we talked about yesterday, the body's expression of universal intelligence, this innate intelligence of life stems directly from the universal intelligence that governs and directs all things. Have you ever heard of the instant headache? I got an instant headache as soon as I smelled this, or as soon as I heard. Instant headache. It's not uncommon for people to experience instant headache when exposed to the fumes of any one of many various chemical toxins. This headache is a correct response by the body. It makes a person aware that all is not well in the environment. Otherwise you wouldn't know. And that either the substance needs to be contained or the person needs to vacate the area in order to maintain health. It's pretty straightforward. This is the law of phenomena. That instant headache is working to your advantage. Two. Example two. Have you ever heard of anybody tell you that they have a bad stomach?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Oh, a bad knee, a bad this.
And I'm thinking, it's like having a bad dog, right? Bad stomach, bad. What do you say to a bad... Can they possibly have a bad stomach?
No.
They got a bad mind.
Oh, I can't eat that. I have a bad stomach is relatively common expression. This expression represents a misunderstanding of how the body works. The stomach's perfect. The stomach is complaining. That is, the symptoms being generated in the stomach region are not because the stomach is bad, but because the stomach is being subjected to substances, forces, influences, or conditions that are not conducive to its overall well-being. This is the law of phenomena. Without the feedback from our various parts to let us know which substances, forces, influences, or conditions are in our best interest and which are destructive to our health, we'd have almost no way of determining this vital information. Let's create the opposition. What would be an example of a way that people live that is in a that is in denial or in opposition of the law of phenomena?
They don't take responsibility for their health.
Depressed people.
I'm sorry?
Depressed people.
What about depressed people?
They always see the negative in everything and they don't believe that things have a good outcome.
And
it's not really the right answer to the question, right? It's just
and the way they think is as powerful to them as aromatherapy, but in a negative direction. It's aroma negative therapy.
Negative
right?
Therapy.
So there was a book written, I'm trying to remember the exact name of the book, the exact title, we'll end up with it. It's something like, you can't afford the luxury of a negative thought. You cannot afford the luxury of one negative thought.
Yeah.
Because every single one of those
has an effect on yourself.
Is essentially a denial or attempting to live in opposition to the law of phenomena, which you cannot live in opposition. You will die in opposition to the law of phenomena. You will die in opposition to any of the laws. all of the laws, any of the laws, each of the laws. So, here's my example. A general opposition to the law of phenomenal is demonstrated when we attempt to treat in order to suppress symptoms of any kind. Oh, you have a headache? Here's some aromatherapy. I'm not picking on you, I'm just playing.
It was just a question, I didn't care. I don't care about that.
Exactly. When we attempt to treat in order to suppress symptoms of any kind, no matter how we treat in order to suppress. Symptoms are bodily generated phenomena that inform us that our style of living has not been conducive to perfect health. Symptoms give us a clear message that the substance's forces, influences, and conditions of life have not been in alignment with those that we require. This equates to the same as someone putting duct tape or paint over the gauges on the dashboard of the car in order not to be bothered by the red lights that just keep glowing there. Those red lights are warnings that something is about to go wrong somewhere, not even necessarily on the dashboard, but somewhere else. Our symptoms are similar warnings. Take heed of the warning, modify and correct the lifestyle, and the body will cease to generate symptoms.
Wow, that's simple.
Remove the cause. So the health philosophy would be based on the concept of removing the cause rather than treating the symptoms.
Well, we're a long ways away.
It's like my sister, she just had her gallbladder taken out.
Oh, gosh.
She's like,
yeah, that offensive gallbladder.
She's, the way she goes on about it, she diverts the blame for, she says, I have a gallbladder problem, instead of, I have a lifetime of eating really terrible deep fried food.
Until my gallbladder failed.
Macaroni and cheese with bacon and,
oh, God.
She's a really sweet person.
But
I'm not the person, right?
You can't blame them. They don't until they get it, they don't get it.
They don't seek it.
If 24/7 they're bombarded by a story that doesn't include this story, you can't expect them to come up with it on their own. Mm-hmm. That's a rare person that comes up with it on their own.
It's not her fault, it's your gallbladder's fault.
It's not her fault. Why is the medical model of suppression and treatment and removal of the offending parts, why is that so popular? And this personal health model,
this doesn't bring them money.
Because we are not willing to take responsibility.
We live in a society of non-responsibility. No matter who gets caught, no matter who gets caught lying, cheating, stealing amongst all of the leaders of the world, they just go, that wasn't me, I'm not responsible, here's what really happened, or some other thing. Nobody's ever responsible, no one is ever accountable. Occasionally they'll make an example of some small fry so that the big fry can continue to play. Mm-hmm. Pia, you're totally correct. The reason that the medical model is so readily accepted and the health model is not is because the people who own the medical model and run the medical model own everything. Media, newspaper, television, educational system,
religion,
drugs,
everything.
Schools, politics, politicians, they own everything.